I'd like to right now also introduce Bernie Farber, who is the former chief executive officer of the Canadian Jewish Congress and a human rights activist. He has testified before the Canadian courts as an expert witness on hate crime. Mr. Farber was on leave from the CJC's successor, the Canadian Council for Israel and Jewish Advocacy, during his candidacy as the Ontario Liberal Party's nominee in the 2011 Ontario election in the riding of Thornhill. Today, Mr. Farber works in partnership with First Nations to help develop sustainable business economies. He also continues to write on human and civil rights issues with the Huffington Post, as well as various newspapers across Canada. Mr. Farber, we welcome you.
Thank you very much. It's appropriate that we gather today, April 23rd. It is the day that recognizes spring in the Roma community worldwide. The term, as I understand it, is Erzelgin, is that correct?
Ergelezi.
Okay, so welcome everybody. A great Jewish philosopher once said that we must always take sides. Silence encourages the victimizer and never the victim. That was Elie Wiesel. And I stand here today taking sides with the Roma community. But at one and the same time, I think it's important that the Canadian community hear from me as to who exactly the Roma community is and where they originally came from here in Canada. The Roma are a small community in Canada, numbering about 80,000. Some families have been living here, believe it or not, since the early part of the 20th century. These families, which still speak the native Romani language and share a culture dating back to the Eastern Europe and share a culture dating back to Central Europe of the 16th century, are now into the fifth and sixth generations. And of course, many more Roma came to Canada during the Hungarian Revolution in 1956. And many more have come in increasing years. And the community has been a peaceful community, a law-abiding community, and a community that has been a credit to this country. So what I'm here to do today, I'm not going to talk about the intricacies of the CRTC. They are going to have to make a decision based on what is before them vis-a-vis Sun News. Ezra Levant engaged in what could only be called a screed, a rant against the Roma community 6 months ago. And many people spoke out, and for that we have to be grateful. 6 months later, I should add though that Sun News did of course apologize a week or so later. That has to be taken into account. And then 6 months later, after a lot of agitation and a lot of work, Ezra Levant went on public airwaves and made an apology. And I know many people here were not happy with the apology, because apologies are just words. In our tradition, in the Jewish tradition, an apology must be accompanied by action. And yeah. So what I want to do, my friends, is I want to strike a note of conciliation. It has always been my way to use education and compromise as a means by which to go forward. It wasn't all that long ago that the Canadian Jewish community faced a very similar situation right here in this country, when Al Jazeera Arabic wanted to get a license from the CRTC to broadcast in this country. There was no doubt about it at that time that Al Jazeera Arabic, as opposed to Al Jazeera English, engaged in some of the most anti-Semitic programs one has ever seen. And so we also opposed the license renewal. But what we did do in the end is we reached a compromise. And I want to suggest a compromise here as well. A compromise that I think is a very Canadian way to move forward, and a compromise that I think can help bring the Roma community together with other production companies, news companies like Sun News. Listen, Sun News isn't everybody's cup of tea. I get it. They take a very specific stand. They are very provocative, but when they move into hate speech, that's where we have to take a stand. So here's what I'm going to suggest. As for Ezra Levant's apology, as I said, an apology is only words if it's not followed by action. My suggestion is that Ezra, in order to show his apology has any meaning at all, should at the very least meet with the Canadian Roma community leadership and perhaps spend some time at the Roma Community Center getting to know this wonderful community. That would be a major step forward. I would also like to suggest that, as with Al Jazeera, when we were dealing with Al Jazeera, that Sun Yu should consider establishing a consultative committee to meet on a regular basis with Roma community leaders to ensure that any of their major concerns are dealt with appropriately. And number three, before any decision is made at this point as to whether or not there should be an expanded license for Sun News, I would suggest that there be a six-month moratorium to ensure that they are compliant with the expected norms and regulations prior to making any final decisions. My friends, we are not here to stifle speech. We are here to encourage civil speech. If indeed Sun News and Ezra Levant can turn that corner and can demonstrate that they can turn that corner and become civil advocates, they can take whatever position that they want to take, from the left to the right to the extreme middle. But if they do it as we do it here in Canada, with civility, then I believe we can move forward. Thank you very much.